Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved ones, today is 29th day of April, being the third week of Easter. Our readings will be coming from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 8, verse 1 to 8. Our responsory psalm will come from Psalm 60, verse 1. Our gospel message will come from John's Gospel, chapter 6, verse 35 to 40. And today, the Mother Church celebrates St. Catherine of Siena. The theme of our message today is the will of the Father. The will of the Father. And that's why the gospel message today continues to announce to us the will of the Father through his own Son. Jesus said, "I have told you, crowd, I'm the bread of life. Anyone who comes to me will never be hungry again. And anyone who believes in me will never thirst again." And he said, "But unfortunately, I've come to you, and many of you didn't believe me." And he said, "Look, no person will come to me unless sent to me by my Father. And the will of my Father is that anyone he sent to me, I will not cast out. But I will raise him up on the last day. I will lose nothing of what he has given me." That's the will of the Father, that I lose nothing he has given me. That I will raise them up on the last day, and I will not cast them out. And the will of the Father is that all who see the Son and believe in him will have eternal life. And I will raise him up on the last day. So it's the will of the Father that all of us should be lost. It's the will of the Father that all of us should live to life. It is the will of the Father that all of us will go to believe in his Son. That's the will of the Father. And in the will of the Father, we have our peace. In the will of the Father, we have our fulfillment. We attain the purpose for which God created us when we are doing the will of the Father. And in doing the will of the Father, we remain blessed and protected. And that way, when you see people doing the will of the Father, they are bound to be persecuted. Because their life contradicts the life of the world and the world life of evil men. And that's why you can see from the Acts of the Apostles today, the church in Jerusalem was subjected to heavy persecution. And they scattered all over the people scattered. Only the apostles were in Jerusalem now. Saul was busy entering house to house, dragging people and committing them to prison for following the word of Christ. So there was confusion and anarchy all over the place. And the disciples scattered. And Philip went to the town of Samaria. And there proclaimed the word of God. That proclaimed the Christ risen from the dead. And many people come to believe in him. When they have seen the miracles he was performing and signs, he heard the sick, then they let him walk again. People who were possessed by a demon, cast out demons from them. And there was a great joy in the town because the people were free. They were in bondage before. When you are not doing the will of the Father, you are in bondage. But when the Son comes into you and you believe in him, you are set free. Philip went setting people who were in bondage free. And there was great joy in that city. And many people come to believe in Jesus Christ. And that is the will of the Father. That people should not live in bondage. He came that we might have life and have it in abundance. He came to bring good news to the poor. He came to liberate people in bondage. He came that we might have life and have it in abundance. He came to let your prayers go free and let the blind see again and to bring favors of God. You can see Luke chapter 4, verse 18. That's the will of the Father. And that's why the will of the Father is the joy of all of us. And that's why the psalmist one that stood in so way today said, "Cry out with joy to the God of all the earth, cry out with joy. The God of all the earth is the God who created the earth and rules the earth. And in him you fulfill the purpose for which you come into this earth. And that's why today the church celebrates St. Catherine of Siena. St. Catherine of Siena, a virgin and doctor of the church, single-handedly sustained the church. So powerful that he fleeced a lot of people and touched the life of so many people. And he was able to convince the Pope to leave Aragon and went go back to Rome, the palace of the Pope. He was able to persuade the Pope to move back. And that will show you the power. Pope Gregory the 11th persuaded him, convinced him, the need for him for to leave Aragon and return to the palace in Rome. He wrote so many books, mystical books. Outstanding one is the Dialogue of St. Catherine of Siena, where he was in dialogue with God for 2 weeks. She saw the meaning of God, she saw the will of God, and drowned herself in doing the will of God. And today she's exalted because she must attend the eternal life. And that's why the church is celebrating her today, a virgin and doctor of the church. We thank God for all the Catholics. We thank God for the gift of this our sister who come to show us that the will of God is the ultimate of life. Doing the will of the Father. We ask God to give us the grace to accept the will of the Father and go about doing his own work so to attend the purpose for which he called us into this earth. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May the blessings of Almighty God be upon all of us as we do the will of the Father. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you all.